Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the fourth part of this flip-flop conversion, we will see that how to convert the T flip-flop into the SR, D as well as the JK flip-flop. So if you have followed the earlier part of the flip-flop conversions, then we have seen that to convert the one flip-flop into the another flip-flop, we need to design the additional combinational circuit. And this circuit needs to be connected between the inputs of the required flip-flop and the inputs of the actual flip-flop. And then we have also seen the steps which we need to follow during the conversion. So by following the same steps, now let us see how to convert the T flip-flop into the SR flip-flop. So here, since the SR flip-flop is our required flip-flop, so first of all, let us write down the truth table of the SR flip-flop. So as you know, for the SR flip-flop, when both inputs are 0, then the flip-flop will retain its current state. Similarly, when the S is 0 and R is 1, then the flip-flop will get reset to 0. Likewise, when the S is 1 and R is 0, then the output of the flip-flop will become 1. And similarly, when both inputs are 1, then the output of the flip-flop is indeterminate. That means for the last two input conditions, it doesn't matter what is the value of the T input. Or we can say that for the last two input conditions, this T input is the don't care term. But apart from that, for the remaining 6 output transitions, let us see what should be the value of the T input. And to find that, we will take the help of the acceleration table of the T flip-flop. So in the earlier video of the T flip-flop, we have already discussed about this acceleration table of the T flip-flop. So in that video, we have seen that whenever there is a 0 to 0 or the 1 to 1 transition, then for such transitions, the required value of the T input is equal to 0. And whenever we have a 0 to 1 or 1 to 0 transition, then for such transitions, the required value of the T input is equal to 1. So this is the excitation table of the T flip-flop. So with the help of this excitation table, now let us complete this table. So as per this excitation table, for this 0 to 0 transition, the required value of the T input should be equal to 0. Likewise, for this 1 to 1 transition also, the required value of the T input is also equal to 0. Similarly, in the third case, for this 0 to 0 transition, once again, this T input will be equal to 0. And whenever we have a 1 to 0 or the 0 to 1 transition, then for such transitions, the required value of the T input is equal to 1. And once again, in the last case, for this 1 to 1 transition, this T input should be equal to 0. So in this way, we have completed the entire table. So now, let us find the expression of the T in terms of the S, R and the Qn. And with the help of that expression, we will be able to design the combinational circuit for the conversion. So if you see over here, then this T input is equal to 1 for the two different input combinations. That is 011 and 100. So if you see the corresponding mean terms, then they are M3 and M4. But apart from that, we also have two don't care terms, that is 110 and 111. And if you see the corresponding mean terms, then they are M6 and M7. So now, let us write down all these mean terms in the K-map. And let us try to find the simplified expression of the T. So here, all the four mean terms are represented in the K-map. So here, with the help of the mean term M3 and M7, we can make the group of these two mean terms. Likewise, with the help of the mean term M4 and the M6, we can make the group of these two mean terms. So in this way, with the help of the two don't care terms, we are able to cover all the mean terms in the K-map. So here, this group corresponds to S dot Qn dash, because in this group, the variable S and Qn is not changing. So in this group, if you see, then the value of the variable S is equal to 1, while the value of the variable Qn is equal to 0. Therefore, this group corresponds to S dot Qn dash. Similarly, this group corresponds to R dot Qn. And if you see the overall expression of the T, then that is the summation of these two terms. That means the T is equal to S dot Qn dash plus R dot Qn. And this is the corresponding logic circuit for the same expression. So here, with the help of the first AND gate, we will get the term S dot Qn dash. Likewise, With the help of the second AND gate, we will get the term r dot qn. And with the help of this OR gate, we will get the summation of these two terms. And the output of this OR gate will be the input of this T flip-flop. So in this way, we can convert this T flip-flop into the SR flip-flop. So similarly, now let us see how to convert the T flip-flop into the JK flip-flop. So once again, since the JK flip-flop is our required flip-flop, so first of all, let us write down the truth table of this JK flip-flop. So as you know, for the JK flip-flop, when both inputs are 0, then the flip-flop will retain its current state. Similarly, when the J is 0 and K is 1, then the flip-flop will get reset to 0. Likewise, when the J is 1 and K is 0, then the flip-flop will get set to 1. And similarly, when both inputs are 1, then the output of the flip-flop will toggle. That means presently, if this Qn is 0, then in the next state it will become 1. And likewise, presently if this Qn is 1, then in the next state it will become 0. So now, to get all these output transitions, let us find the required value of the T input. And for that, once again, we will take the help of the excitation table of the T flip-flop. So as you can see from the excitation table, for the 0 to 0 transition and the 1 to 1 transition, the required value of the T input is equal to 0. That means in the first three cases, the required value of the T input is equal to 0. But whenever we have a 1 to 0 or the 0 to 1 transition, then the required value of the T input is equal to 1. That means in the next two cases, the required value of the T input is equal to 1. Now then after, for this 1 to 1 transition, once again, the required value of the T input is equal to 0. And then, for the 0 to 1 and 1 to 0 transitions, the required value of the T input is equal to 1. So in this way, we got the required value of the T input for all these transitions. So now, let us find the expression of the T in terms of the inputs JK and the QN. So if you see over here, then this T is equal to 1 for the 4 different input combinations. That is 011, 100, 110 and 111. And if you see the corresponding min terms, then they are M3, M4, M6 and M7. So first of all, let us write down all these min terms in the K map. And let us try to find the simplified expression of the T. So here, all the min terms have been represented in the K map. So once again, here with the help of the min term M3 and M7, we can make the group of these two min terms. And likewise, with the help of the min term M4 and M6, we can cover these two min terms. So here, this group corresponds to J dot Qn dash. And similarly, this group corresponds to K dot Qn. That means if we see the expression of the T, then it is the summation of these two terms. That means T is equal to J dot Qn dash plus K dot Qn. And if you see this expression, then it is very similar to the expression which we got for the SR flip-flop. That means if we see the required logic circuit, then it is also very similar to the SR flip-flop conversion. So here, with the help of the first AND gate, we will get the term J dot Qn dash. Similarly, with the help of the second AND gate, we will get the term K dot Qn. And with the help of this OR gate, we will get the summation of these two terms. So here, the output of the OR gate will be given as the input to this T flip-flop. And in this way, we can convert this T flip-flop into the JK flip-flop. So similarly, now let us see how to convert the T flip-flop into the D flip-flop. So here, since the D flip-flop is our required flip-flop, so first of all, let us write down the truth table of the T flip-flop. So as you know, for the T flip-flop, the output in the next state is same as the input. That means whenever this D input is equal to 0, then the output is also equal to 0. And likewise, when the D input is equal to 1, then the output is also equal to 1. So now, to get all these output transitions, let us find the required value of the T input. And for that, once again we will take the help of the excitation table. So as you can see from the excitation table, to get this 0 to 0 transition, the required value of the T input is equal to 0. Likewise, for this 1 to 0 transition, the required value of the t input is equal to 1. And likewise, for the 0 to 1 transition also, this t input should be equal to 1. And lastly, for this 1 to 1 transition, the required value of the t input is equal to 0. So in this way, we found the required value of the t input for all the transitions. So now, let us find the expression of the t in terms of the d and qn, where the d is the input of the required flip-flop and the qn is the present state of the t flip-flop. So if you see over here, then this t is equal to 1 for the two different input combinations, that is 0, 1 and 1, 0. So if you see the corresponding min terms, then they are m1 and m2. So here, this first term corresponds to d bar dot qn, and the second term corresponds to d dot qn bar. That means if we see the expression of the t, then it is equal to d dot qn bar plus d bar dot qn. Or we can say that that is equal to dx or qn. So with the help of the one XOR gate, we can convert this t flip-flop into the d flip-flop. So in this way, we have seen that how to convert the t flip-flop into the SR, D as well as the JK flip-flop. So in case if you haven't watched the earlier three parts of the videos, then I will provide the link for those videos in the description. But in general, if you have any questions or suggestions, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.